All right, time for another episode of the Joshcast, which I'm basically doing once a week now, so that I can also do my other podcast, the Sci-Fi Podcast, once a week as well. So I have two podcasts going per week, with the production value of 0.002 podcasts, if you will. So, I want to talk about erectile dysfunction today. Erectile dysfunction. Erectile dysfunction. Why go on living? So, I've only been intimate, if you will, four times in my life. And while I didn't have, you know, a total failure of all the working parts, I was kind of in and out. I had trouble maintaining. And I am now feeling like if I'm ever in a situation where I'm intimate again, this is a concern of mine. Am I going to be able to perform? It's odd that that is the word that they use to describe it, perform. I have a BFA in theater, and yet I cannot perform! Your performance. How was your performance? What am I, a Tesla? Feels like a very, it's a term you apply to a car. I don't know. And I'm worried that I'm not going to be able to measure up. The other thing I've noticed is that whenever I try talking about this, inevitably the penis puns just flow. And I never feel good about that either. Because the last thing I want this podcast to devolve into is a meandering litany of crass remarks. So what do I do about this? Well, what I shouldn't do is Google it, that's for sure, because Google is just going to try to sell me drugs. Google has become the drug pusher of the 21st century. All these paid ads for Viagra and what have you, and I don't know that that is the... I'm afraid to take any prescription drugs of any kind. Even if I absolutely have to take a prescription drug, which I might have to start taking something for cholesterol, I'm terrified of it because my theory is that anything that you put in your body will have an effect of some, a side effect of some kind. And if there's a drug out there, like right now, this cholesterol drug, what everyone keeps saying is, oh yeah, yeah, just take it, then you can eat whatever you want, and there's no side effect. If there's no side effect, all that that means is that there have not been any or enough lawsuits. That's all that means. No side effect. There's always a side effect. I feel like modern living is just deciding, how am I going to die? How would I like to go out? Well, if I don't take the cholesterol, it'll be, boom, dead of a stroke. If I do take the cholesterol medication, it'll be... it could still be boom, dead of a stroke. Or whatever the side effects are of the cholesterol medication. Which, who knows what it is. Ironically, it might be erectile dysfunction. So the good news is, I guess if that is the side effect, oh well. I'm one step ahead of you. One step ahead of you, Captain. I gotta say, the traffic right now, truly phenomenal. Because people are still away for the holidays. So it's the one time driving through Los Angeles feels like not driving through Los Angeles. It feels like driving through any other city. It probably feels like driving through Cleveland, even though I've never been through Cleveland. I've been through Denver recently. Denver is getting, the traffic is getting worse. Because they're growing at an exponential rate. And they have freeways that were designed for, you know, 1960s. they're going to have the same problem that LA has in short order. But that's not what I'm here to talk about. I'm here to talk about erectile dysfunction. Did you know that 7 out of 10 men, blah, 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 erectile dysfunction? I don't think it's that high a percentage. If it were, we wouldn't have an overpopulation problem. So I don't know what to do about it. I don't know what to do about it. I mean, fortunately, it's not a, you know, I'm not in a relationship, so it's not a problem. It's not an immediate problem. But it begs the question, it adds to my general anxiety about the prospect of dating. Because how do I not bring this up at the beginning? How do I not bring up full disclosure? I don't want her getting all the way to the bedroom and then finding out, uh-oh. So and people are like, well, you need to have more confidence when you're dating. In what? In what exactly? Well, I'm not mean. How about that, ladies? I don't have confidence. And I say that I don't have confidence with confidence. And with pride. Because I'm tired of lying. And I'm tired of putting on a show for people. That's not who I really am. I'm tired of confidence. I'm tired of being told to have confidence. I'm tired of confident people. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear what you've learned. I don't want to hear your hot take. I want to give my hot take and then qualify my hot take with, but remember, I can't get it up. I got to tell you, I think in a way it's part of the reason why I like stand-up so much. It's the one opportunity where I'm the only one talking. And I don't have to worry about other people's opinions. Are my opinions necessarily better than other people's opinions? No, but for one brief moment, I can pretend they are. And that is the glory of stand-up comedy. Did not get a lot of sleep last night. I was up pretty early at 4 in the morning. And I was thinking about erectile dysfunction. So now I have erectile dysfunction and insomnia. One does not help the other, I'll tell you that. Again, I want to emphasize that it's mild erectile dysfunction. I mean, I got through it. That's how I describe sex. I got through it. I describe it like it's the SAT test. Or the LSAT. I'm going to be an attorney, but just barely. That's what it felt like. Not that I've ever taken the LSAT, but I think you catch my drift. So where does that leave me? Where does that leave any of us? I did look up holistic methods of curing erectile dysfunction. There are yoga poses that are supposed to help. One of them is the simple meditation pose, the sitting cross-legged. So all roads lead back to meditation. I have a feeling that meditation is not going to help with erectile dysfunction. All meditation will help with is perhaps, at a high Buddhist level, accepting erectile dysfunction. It'll help me ascend to a plane of existence where I don't have to worry about erectile dysfunction anymore because I'm just energy. And everyone knows that when two bits of energy has sex with each other, there's no need to worry about erectile dysfunction because they trade protons or whatever it is energy beings do when they have sex. Maybe they trade electrons. There's a chemical, I don't know, I'm not sure. I'm not on speaking terms with any energy beings. That I'm aware of, at least. I do think it's important to talk about this. Because, for two reasons. Number one, I'm hoping that talking about it will help exorcise the demon, as it will. Because I read somewhere that the more you tell your story, the more you can process the story. And if it's one thing I want to get to the point of being at, it's processing having a questionable penis. Because once I've processed it, then I don't know. I'm not seeing the post-processing. I'm not seeing a light at the end of the tunnel on this one. I'm struggling to get through the tunnel. There's not enough length to get through the tunnel. You see, already. The metaphors just take care of themselves, don't they? Don't they just take care of themselves? Figured I'd give a pregnant pause. Pregnant's not the word I want to use right now. That's the one thing I don't have to worry about worrying about right now. I also figured it'd be good to talk about this because maybe other people are going through it too. And I don't know. Something about how it's good to know you're not alone. You know, that has never helped me. You're not alone. You know, other people go through this too. Whether it's this or depression. Other people go through depression too, Josh. Well, do other people have the cure? Then I don't care. You're not the only one going through this, Josh. You're not the only one. Well, what do you want us to do? All get in a room together so that we can collectively feel horrible? Misery loves company, Josh. I don't know why that's suddenly, now that I think about it, I don't know why that sentiment is a form of, what's the word I'm looking for? I don't know why that people think that will make me feel better when they say, you're not alone. Other people are going through this too. Okay, great. I mean, if I'm being thrown out of a plane on the way down, it's not useful for me to call me and say, hey, just want to let you know other people are currently being thrown out of a plane right now. So rest easy. At least you're not the only one being thrown out of a plane. Wouldn't that be embarrassing? I mentioned depression, something else I have. I think there are links between depression and erectile dysfunction. Does one cause the other? I don't know, but I see them living in the same house. Depression and erectile dysfunction definitely are roommates. Depression has the master bedroom. Erectile dysfunction doesn't take up too much space. Hey! Comedy podcast. Depression does not do the dishes. Erectile dysfunction never speaks up. Rage has to do all the talking for it. This is turning into the adult version of the Pixar movie Inside Out, where depression, erectile dysfunction, regret, those are all the characters driving the boat. Now that's a movie I want to see, where they're all voiced by Lewis Black. Driving by this place called Liquor. U-M. That Liquor. I think that's, again, I've said this before on previous podcasts. I will say it again. This is the greatest name for any business ever. Where do you work? Liquor. That's fantastic. I need to go in there and just ask them, what is this name? Where did you... Please tell me it means what I think it means. Because it's either that, or I suppose it's a... It's a name of a clearly, you know, some kind of foreign name of some kind. Even if that's true, they should deny it and just say that it's called Liquor, because what do you want to call the store? Liquor. That has to be it. That has to be it. It must be it. It must be it, my friends. It must be it. Well, I'm in a slap-happy sort of mood. I'm going to go have my morning tea. I ordered a dessert pizza last night. I ate half of it. I have the other half of it in the refrigerator at the office so that I can continue to make bad food decisions. Because, by God, I deserve a marshmallow after what I've been through. And I guess that's the end of the podcast. So look at that, 16 minutes. Normally it takes me 18 to 20 minutes to get here. And that's what happens in holiday LA traffic. Goodbye!